Holy shit, you gotta be.
Look, I'm helping you. You gotta help me too. I need your story live on Monday. It's sweep week, man.
Sweep week? Man, fuck a sweep week. You got me out here wanted for murder. You talking about a goddamn room and shit. And then you get back. What is this sweet, sweet thing here?
You better not be lying to me.
The hell I gotta lie to you for?
No, your type operates.
My type? So why the hell you took my type to your goddamn dinner rehearsal for a damn story?
Stuck with you.
Please stuck with shit. When I figured your white ass out.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you're full of shit. I have desperate ass middle class white boy. Don't give a damn who you step on. Get what you want. That's what you like. You get your priority stripped. My turn. Y'all goddamn right.
I'm a large murder.
Look, man, I'm sick of your smart ass comments. You know you heard of no goddamn body. You be running this shit in the first place. I was down there minding my own goddamn business, living ghetto fabulous. I won't mess with nobody. You can't even fuck that up. You know how much money I was making out of that goddamn car wash, huh?
About 298.
I would slap you, man. I would slap the hell out of you. You don't play with me. You don't know who messed with me. I don't even know what I would slap somebody. My reflexes just slap people. I'd be like, damn. I don't know what I'm gonna slap somebody. You keep messing with me. I'm dangerous. I'm scared of myself. They call me Snap and Pop because I snap and I will pop your ass in the mouth. Don't mess with me, man. You better watch your back. Watch your goddamn back. Even in the shower, even at picnics, you better watch your goddamn back. Think about it.
What the fuck up, world? What the fuck up, world? We back at it. We back at it. Exposing this scammer. You understand? Straight scammer. As you can see, man, dude got the Astro World motherfucker tattoo. We're gonna go through a couple of more pictures. As you can see, advertising the Astro World. Also throwing up the one-eyed symbol. We're looking to the, you gotta understand, yeah. Looking to the left, throwing up the one-eyed symbol, looking out. That's the way to, got the Mason beard, got the Mason bald head, obviously in the game. You know what I'm saying? Check it out. That probably might be the same cross he wore at the concert. You understand? Uh-huh. Now explain to people whose gear is this? Whose gear is this?
That is Travis Scott's gear. Yep, right there, if you look in, that is Cactus Jack. All over there.
And we see the hashtag Cactus Jack for what? For life, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So check this out. Next picture. See him stunting with the Astro World, but you got to understand, you got to check the black and white and then check the five-pointed star. This shit deep. You understand? So it's obviously something he wants you to see embedded inside of the actual tattoo. And this was August 9th, 2020. So that wasn't his first concert. Now, here is a funny-ass looking picture. Y'all want y'all to look at this picture real carefully. This shit is funny to me because these don't look like the same kids. You understand? Well, this don't look like the same Ezra, allegedly. You understand? I don't know the date of this picture, but it don't look like it don't look like what I've been showing y'all. And here we go with a Nike outfit. You understand? Standing in front of the Nike store. I think the actual check in the Nike actually was like a logo for the victory of the lesbians or some shit like that. I mean, it's some weird ass shit, but yeah. Like, that don't look like the same child. Like, I don't know, I'm just saying. I just thought I'd put that out there. Once again, we see the same little boy. Does that look like Ezra? I'm asking y'all. You know what I'm saying? Does this look like an advertisement picture? And this picture was December 14th, 2020. Last time he allegedly seen his kid. Now, features don't change that much. You understand? Features don't change that much. Talking about hashtag daddy day. Look, man, where's the mama? If all this happened, where's the mama? Let's see. And here's Ezra. You understand? And here also is the fucking GoFundMe that was started that Monday. Started that Monday. Created November 8th, that Monday. Medical illnesses and healing. GoFundMe, bro. Right into, I'm telling y'all, ran right into a scam. A scam, bro. Bro, if you can't read the so-called alleged eulogy for me.
Oh, I don't think I found the eulogy. I think I can pull it up. I got
it. Oh, well, yeah.
It says, family and friends will say their final goodbyes to 9-year-old Ezra Blunt at a funeral scheduled for Tuesday morning in Dallas, according to his grandmother, Teresa Blunt. The funeral is scheduled for 11 a.m. at the Inspiring Body of Christ Church, located at 7701 South Westmoreland Road. Little Ezra was the youngest victim to die in the Astro Festival tragedy.
Nothing about the little boy's life, right?
It says, Ezra had been on a ventilator and was in a medically induced coma in Texas Children's Hospital since was injured. He suffered severe injuries during the crowd surge on the night of November 5th, according to his grandmother.
To his who?
His grandmother.
Oh, Annie.
Somebody who we ain't even seen. But, go ahead.
Ezra Blunt was the 10th person to die from injuries sustained during Scott's performance at Astro Festival.
I'm going to just point this at 10, the number of completion. Just thought I'd throw that in there. But go ahead.
Photos shared by the family show Ezra and his father, Tristan Blunt, at the festival before the chaos that led to death of nine other young people. Ezra Unt said that the boy was an outgoing performer who loved to sing and dance. Travis Scott is his favorite rapper. So
now, you know what's so crazy about that shit? And you know what's so crazy about that shit? Mm-hmm. I actually, if y'all go back to the earlier videos, I actually did a, you know what I'm saying? Like a definition defining Mr. Ezra Blunt's name. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, I don't even think that was this little boy's real name. I'm trying to figure out if it was the same little boy. But where's Ben Crump ass at? Let's go and get him out the way. Because this motherfucker is the actor of all actors. Mr. Ben Crump. And as you can see, previously watched. And would you say he was fun and outgoing, right? Mm-hmm. Now, bro, look at this shit. I want you to look at it. And tell me that shit don't creep you out.
Help. Yep, that's what he was screaming that night.
That's what that was the whole narrative.
A boy screaming for help.
Check this out, finna freak you out now. Now the concert. Hold on now. Now check this out. I pointed this out. Now what that say? What those colors say?
Turquoise, green, blue, white, light blue.
Now, what you see in that little boy Nike outfit? Do you not see those same colors? When you look at that boy Nike outfit, go ahead, look at it. But no, I mean, go ahead, look at it on your phone. Not his Nike outfit.
Who's on?
Ezra.
That is Ezra.
No, the other one, the other Ezra.
Am I this one?
Yeah.
Oh, you talking about the word?
Yeah, just look. I mean, even in the hat and shit. You know what I'm saying? So, let's keep on going. Turn the fuck your head up. What day the concert was? What was the day? Thursday, Friday, what was the day? Friday, right?
Yeah.
What'd that say?
Wednesdays.
No. Go back. I want you to read carefully the whole thing. Watch.
Lucky days for Ezra's are Wednesdays and Fridays.
The concert was when?
Friday.
Now, you see this? Bright, courageous, bold, right? Now, I'm pointing this out. He is ambitious and competitive, too. This is just describing the energy of a person named Ezra, right? not a person's name, not an actual person. So with that being said, check this out. And it goes on and on. And I point that out to say this. Watch this here. I'm going to show you something real quick. Show all y'all something real quick. Let's go to the auntie. Where you at? Where you at? Oh, right here. Come on.
Just sent to me here just a little while ago, showing.
We'll be blind to him, and he passed out.
Well, while we here, we're going to go ahead and go get on the goddamn granddaddy, too. And I'm going to learn you something.
It was an exciting time for this father and his son. They came from Dallas for the show. And as I mentioned, loved Travis Scott, the child. He was on his father's shoulders, and he actually fell from his
See the turquoise
shoes.
And shit?
I want you to take a listen to how his grandfather described exactly what happened there as he had his son up there to protect him from the crowd surge.
And my son
pull up that GoFundMe
with all the pressure that was being applied to him, and he passed out. And when he passed out, that's what fell into the crowd. And he was trampled really bad.
He had the cutest dimple. He loves.
Now check this out. Now I'm gonna break this down real quick, and I'm gonna show you something again. Now the grandfather. I'm gonna show you something.
And he actually fell from his dad's shoulders. I want you guys to take a listen to how his grandfather described exactly what happened there as he had his son up there to protect him from the crowd surge.
And my.
First of all, the act of him falling off the shoulders is the act of baptism, an act of sacrifice. You understand? You gotta look at it in a holistic view. See the gray heat his father got on? Mm-hmm. That's actually black and white. Masonic shit. You see the beard? Mm-hmm. Masonic shit. Bald head, Masonic shit. You understand? So listen to what he says. I want you to read that. Read the GoFundMe.
It says, "Hi, I am Tristan Blunt. I am starting this fundraiser for my son. He's 9 years old. His name is Ezra Blunt. We attended the Travis Scott Astroworld Fest. I had my son on my shoulders awaiting Drake's stage appearance. I began to be crushed until I couldn't breathe. I passed out. And I woke up and my son was gone, and due to his severe injuries, which are swelling in the back of brain damage and trauma to nearly all organs, we are certain that he was trampled and is still in an induced coma. We are thankful for his life and thankful for all the prayers and positivity. We are asking for donations for his medical bills and anything that comes along with this tragedy."
Boom, that was on Monday. Now here's his granddaddy on Monday, Mason, with the whole storyline ready. Now y'all listen to this same story. Like they had a script down pat.
Son couldn't breathe because of all the pressure that was being applied to him, and he passed out. And when he passed out, that's what fell into the crowd. And he was trampled really bad.
He had the cutest dimple.
And listen, when Mason and Eastern Stars are trying to convince you of something, they use the hand symbols. You know what I'm saying? It's an act of magic, you know what I'm saying, to garner actual attention. Now, I want you to check out his quote-unquote auntie / Eastern Star. First of all, you see the black and white, right? Mm-hmm. Now, check out her hands. Now, we just seen the meaning of Ezra, right? Mm-hmm. Now, watch. She sit up there and give us the meaning of Ezra. They don't know this little boy. Even if that was their family member, you understand? But I'm putting everything on the table.
He loves to sing. He is.
I want you guys to take a listen to how his grandfather described exactly what happened there as he had his son up there to protect him from the crowd surge.
And my son couldn't breathe because of all the pressure that was being applied to him, and he passed out. And when he passed out, that's what fell into the crowd. And he was trampled really bad.
He had the cutest dimple. He loves to sing. He is so outgoing. He loves music, and he loves skateboards, and he's just a normal, a normal child. He was spending time with his dad, and he loves that.
Chauncey and Lara.
What'd you have to say, bro?
Oh, he was looking to the left a lot. He was lying. He couldn't remember the script.
He couldn't remember the script. This is why they took Tristan ass off the strip. He was the first one to talk. You can't find that interview anywhere. She the one who giving all the interviews. So I went and tried to find the interview. You cannot go find the fucking interview because they scrapped that shit. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I'm telling y'all, this is a fucking money grab. What else I was from the, Mr. Ben Crump ass. We ain't done with Ben. Ben, bring his ass here. He always falling his ass off into the shits. Come here, Ben. Where your ass at? Oh, here we go, Ben.
Cook this in your kitchen if you would like to grow your little friend that lives there in your pants. Reaser.
Another person now who attended Travis Scott's Astroworld concert has died. The family of Barty Shinani, a 22-year-old Texas A&M student, says she was set to graduate next spring. The death toll is now up to 9. This comes as a 9-year-old boy who attended the festival remains in a medically induced coma. His family tells our Derek Lewis today, the little boy is no longer responsive. BNC's Derek Lewis has more from the family, their attorney, and the latest on the investigation.
I spoke with Ezra Blunt's grandmother over the phone briefly. She says right now, the family is asking for prayers. Ezra Blunt is in a Houston hospital with life-threatening injuries. He went to Astroworld with his dad and became separated during the crowd surge. He suffered injuries to his heart, lungs, and brain. Trisha Blunt, his grandmother, says...
Same story narrative. Heart, lungs, and brains. By this time, Ezra in the hospital long enough to get a approximate diagnosis, right, of what's wrong with him, right? You understand?
Like, what was the actual cause of death?
Like, bro, was he even at the... Like, bro, we seen them outside of a building that looked like a hospital. We don't know. You know what I'm saying? He already gave the motherfucker an acronym, bro. This, you know what I'm saying? This is cold like a motherfucker. I'm talking about EB. Anyway.
And we're praying for a miracle.
For a third and final day, attorneys have been able to visit concert grounds to collect evidence through pictures and...
For him to use the word miracle, it's cold. All this shit is cold, man. This shit is cold. And I think it has something to do with, like I was telling people, look up... Shit. Go to Google, look up the meaning of damn what that shit is. It'll come back to me. Damn, I'm trying to think. Hold on. But yeah, bro, infinite limbo. Go ahead. Read it.
The limbo of infants is the hypothetical permanent status of the unbaptized who die in infancy, too young to have committed actual sins but not have been freed from original sin.
And they keep hollering, what? Little Ezra is what? Innocent, right? Mm-hmm. It's going to take a miracle to save little EB, right? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? This is a fucking ritual, bro. Mm-hmm. This is how you point out rituals. But check this out. This is the last thing I'm going to show. And, I just want to show y'all the people who he's representing. Y'all tell me if this real.
That don't fly straight. Neither do you, friend.
And fuck her too. I put you in. So we had a few differences, huh? No big deal. I gave you a start. I was the only one in you.
I stay loyal to you. I may well have put up a sign, but I never tired of you, Frank. Never. You. Man ain't got a sword. It's a cockroach. Your dream. You can do second chance. I keep killing dollars. $100. I kind of report them if they're a state. Come over there. You can have a play. And it's yours. Okay? $30. Okay, then? Please tell me. It'll be a hat. When I saw it,
I took that piece of shit. No.